हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर फिजिक्स क्लास. दिस इज़ योर फिजिक्स टीचर. आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल. इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव स्टार्टेड मेजरमेंट ऑफ टेम्परेचर. नाउ इन दिस वीडियो यू विल लर्न अबाउट थर्मोमीटर, द थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ थर्मोमीटर्स, लेबोरेटरी थर्मोमीटर, क्लिनिकल थर्मोमीटर एंड डिजिटल थर्मोमीटर. इन द पिक्चर यू कैन सी अ थर्मोमीटर. थर्मो मीन्स हीट एंड मीटर मीन्स मेजरमेंट. So thermometer is a device which is used to measure the amount of heat energy present in a body, or it is used to measure the temperature of a body. Now let us see the construction or the parts of a thermometer. It consists of a long cylindrical glass tube of narrow diameter over which markings are made corresponding to different temperature scales that can be in degree Celsius, Kelvin or in degree Fahrenheit. This long cylindrical glass tube is known as stem. It has a bulb at one end containing a liquid which can be either mercury or alcohol. These two liquids are known as thermometric fluids which are used to measure temperature of a body. The bulb is the part of the thermometer that actually touches the object whose temperature is to be measured. There is a tube of very narrow diameter inside the stem, which is known as the capillary tube, and it is also known as the bore. The rising or falling of the mercury or alcohol takes place in this capillary tube. Now let us see the working of thermometer. A thermometer works on the principle that a liquid expands on heating and it contracts on cooling. So when we insert the bulb of the thermometer into the body whose temperature is to be measured, the heat energy of the body causes the fluid in the thermometer to expand and moves up in the tube. And on cooling, the level of the mercury in the capillary tube moves down. There are different types of thermometers which have been classified according to their usage, like laboratory thermometer, clinical thermometer, digital thermometer, and maximum and minimum thermometers. So firstly, we are going to study about laboratory thermometer. A laboratory thermometer is used for measuring the temperature of various objects in the laboratory for conducting scientific experiments. In the picture, you can see a laboratory thermometer. A thermometer has the same construction as I described earlier. It consists of two glass tubes, one placed inside the other. The inner tube is a capillary tube, which is also known as a bore. The upper end of the bore is sealed or closed, and the lower end is connected to a glass bulb which is filled with mercury. The outer tube is called stem, but the temperature markings on this laboratory thermometer is from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. Next is how to read temperature of an object correctly. As we know that mercury and alcohol are the shiny liquids which are kept in a capillary tube, so these can be seen through the stem as a thin shining thread. And by noting down the level of mercury in the capillary tube, we can measure the temperature reading in a laboratory thermometer. Whenever we are going to measure the temperature of any substance, we should note down the initial level of mercury in the capillary tube. So when the thermometer comes in contact with the hot object, the mercury gets heated and the level of mercury rises in the capillary tube. The marking up to which the level of mercury rises in the capillary tube will give the temperature of the object. Here we have some precautions that we can follow while doing a measurement with the laboratory thermometer. First is, the thermometer should be kept upright as shown in pictures A, B and C, and it should not be tilted as shown in the picture D. Secondly, the mercury bulb should be properly dipped into the substance or in the liquid as shown in the picture A. And the third one is, the bulb should not touch the base or the sides of the container in which the substance or the liquid is kept. Next is clinical thermometer. A clinical thermometer is used to measure the temperature of human body. It is also known as doctor's thermometer or the medical thermometer. It is mostly used at home, in the doctor's clinic and in the hospitals. Here you can see a clinical thermometer in which there is glass tube and a mercury filled bulb at one of its ends, and there is fine capillary tube in which mercury or alcohol is kept. There are Celsius and Fahrenheit scales on either side of the mercury thread, and the range of clinical thermometer in degree Celsius is from 35 degree Celsius to 42 degree Celsius, and it is 95 degree Fahrenheit to 108 degree Fahrenheit on Fahrenheit scale. The construction of clinical thermometer is same as that of the laboratory thermometer, with the exception that there is a kink or small constriction in the capillary tube just above the bulb. So this is done to ensure that the mercury level does not drop down quickly. For example, a clinical thermometer is placed inside the mouth for measuring body temperature. Then the heat of the body will heat up the mercury, and the mercury will expand, and the level of mercury rises in the capillary tube. So when the thermometer is taken out of the mouth, the reading of the thermometer does not change. Why it happens? We know that there is a small constriction or kink which prevents the mercury from flowing back into the bulb. Or we can say the mercury column breaks, and thus the liquid or the mercury do not flow back into the tube and thus remains stationary in the tube. Next is reading a clinical thermometer correctly. How we can measure correct temperature with the help of a clinical thermometer? So for this, take a thermometer and give it gentle jerks so that the level of mercury falls below the normal mark, that is 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. Then keep the thermometer under the tongue of the person whose temperature is to be taken, or in the armpit of the children, and then wait for a minute and take out the thermometer out of the mouth. Now hold the thermometer horizontally in your hand and rotate slowly until you see the mercury thread in the tube. The mark where the mercury thread or the level ends, it will give the temperature of the body. What precautions can be taken while reading the clinical thermometer? Firstly, while reading the thermometer, our eyes should be directly overhead the level, otherwise it can lead to a parallax error. Secondly, always hold the thermometer from the tube or stem and not from the bulb. Third is, make sure that the thermometer is washed before and after every use. And the next one is, before measuring the temperature of a person, always shake the thermometer so that the mercury level falls below the normal mark. While shaking, hold it firmly so that it does not fall or break. We should take care one more thing, that in case of kids, it is advisable to use digital thermometers in place of the clinical thermometers to avoid any dangers resulting from the breakage of mercury level in the mouth of children. Next is hyperthermia and hypothermia. So what is hyperthermia or hypothermia? Our body temperature does not remain the same, and it changes throughout the day. It is lowest during early morning and highest in the early evening. So when the body temperature becomes higher than the normal temperature of 98.6 degree Fahrenheit, then that condition is called hyperthermia. And if the body temperature falls below the normal value, then it is known as hypothermia. Next is digital thermometer. A digital thermometer is a device which is used to measure human body temperature very accurately and safely. As in case of clinical thermometer, there is a risk or danger of breaking the mercury bulb in the mouth of children. So in place of the clinical thermometer, we can use a digital thermometer, because these type of thermometers do not contain any liquid, and they measure temperature using an electrical component called thermistor. Thermistor means thermo resistor. A thermistor is a resistance thermometer or a resistor whose resistance depends on temperature. The thermistors are thermally sensitive resistors whose main function is to detect precise change in electrical resistance according to corresponding change in temperature. The digital thermometers are highly accurate and deliver quick results in digital digits. These can be carried very easily, and the temperature displayed can be read more conveniently than a glass thermometer.